Hello again. Okay, where are we at? Oh yeah, back at the thing. Right, so what we've done is we've built our basic kind of cannon thing. I wonder what it looks like with the mesh smooth on. Oh god. So what I'm going to do now is add some detail to it. So where was I? Yeah. So, needless, mindless detail. I'm going to add lots and lots of it to this for, well, for the sakes of just adding mindless quantities of details, really. So what I'm going to do first is go up top where this bit is. And do a quick insert. Not a very big one. About there. Now I can do an extrude straight up. Then grab this bit, extrude it back a bit. Now a quick hinge from edge. Pick this hinge. Do a 90 degree on 5. And just extrude it down. Ooh, sugar lumps, wrong bit. Sugar lumps, good God. There we go. Like so. Now, we'll select there and there. Spin it around. And just do a loop. Just going to go in here and do these pieces. Oops. And again over here. Don't need to do the underside. I will do this bit here though. Okay, and a quick chamfer. Right, now I've got some space to put some, well, basically put some buttons on it. What I'm going to do is, again, I'm going to use the placement tool system, and that will allow us to put basically LEDs and pointless crap onto our model that we don't need, but which will look nice. So for this, I'm going to build myself a new table. There we go. And get started with a cylinder. Just use auto grid. Six-sided ones are ideal, really. Just bring the radius in and the height down. Convert to edible poly. And just do a quick chamfer on these edges. Yes, this is going to push our polygon count through the roof, incidentally. But hey, if you want low polygon counts, you wouldn't be on 3D Palette, so that's okay. And a quick mesh smooth. Before I do that, quick insert again. Then a quick mesh smooth. Then a grow. Delete. Cap. Small extrude and a tiny bevel. We like so. There we go. And that creates for us a kind of a bolt, which is ideal because I'll be able to bolt on the sides of this now with it. Okay, what else can we do? Well, we can do a quick LED. And they're always fun. So, for that, I'm going to do another cylinder, just a small one. Up the sides to about 12. Convert to edible poly. Grab that, control, select by edge and chamfer, bring that down to about 0.1. Now bring it down even more. There we go. Berlin. Minus 0.04. Minus 0.04. Okay, and now for a slightly more complicated beveling procedure. That. Okay, now for names, this becomes, get rid of our magic floating table, a bolt 01, and this becomes LED 01. Okay, now for my next trick, max script, run script. Placement tool, you may remember this from earlier. Hide and selected. We need to concentrate more. Hide and selected. Okay, now this is our source. This is our distribution piece 1. And this is 2. I'm not going to use 2 yet. And we're going to place. So I'm going to put the bolts on the sides. And the good thing is that if I click and hold the clicker down, well, the left mouse button, I can spin it round a bit so it's not completely even. It's too high. Another good thing is that I can use the verts and edges that are visible. Because I'm using shaded faces here, to actually act as guides for me. Yeah, so we're going for the heavy machinery kind of lumped in place here. Maybe an adjustment bolt just about there. About halfway along there and there. Oops, just placed one in the middle of nowhere. Okay, I don't need to put any really underneath. Might put one here. All about really just building things to catch the eye so that people are paying attention to various parts of your model. If I've got a large empty piece, I tend to like to put a little something on it. Okay, let's use a secondary distribution. And over here, use this to line them up with. Quite a hard line of these fellows up, to be honest. So. Okay, go over this side. Too close, that's okay then. It can be quite tricky placing these, to be honest. So. Well, it's sometimes easier, once you get to this point, take off place grab your single LED. Basically knock out a couple of them that we don't need. Because as we know, in the future everything will rely on gigantic chunky LEDs and big diodes. Don't want too many of these. Okay, that's fine. Now, distribution object one again. Offset. There we are. Yep, that's fine. Put another two, one and two. Oops. Okay, that's fine. Turn off place. And get rid of our spares. Okay, our gun's now starting to come together, and we can now attach all. Okay, unhide all. Certainly starting to get there now. Now I need to line up the pivot on this. That way we can set up some basic rocker action on it. Let's check that. I mean, it's not got very much rotation on it, but it's got enough to like kind of thing, yeah? Right, now out of here. This is where we're going to do our wires coming out, I think, or cable or whatever. It will go into our control box. Do that in a minute. For that, though, I need to do a cylinder. I'm going to draw on the side here initially. Then I'm going to align it to the pivot point on this. Then I'm going to bring it out again. Okay, and increase our sides up to about 22. Then a little bit of beveling. Just like that. It doesn't need to be complicated, really. Copy on the x-axis. And just bring it through like that. Okay, next, I'm going to take this piece, and what am I going to do with it again? I'm trying to remember. Oh yeah, duh. Reset X form on it. I'll turn it. Oops. Oh, God, that's loud in my earphones. Reset the X form. Nearly pooed myself. Right, Control A, and just flip that over. Gives you a mad old shape, doesn't it? Look at that. It's quite funky though. But it's a bit crap. Just wanted to see what it looked like. Anyway, what was I up to? Oh yeah. Let's attach those on. So, attach, there, and there. What this means now is when we rotate it, they rotate too. See? Like that. Okay, now what I need to do over here, build another part, which is going to be a cylinder. Looks like our old friend Mr. Auto Grid don't want to have nothing to do with this today, so there we are. Bring that along a bit. There we go. Quick bevel. There we go, just like that. And I was thinking, you see, if I attach a lot of thin wires, you wouldn't really have them coming out the back of something like this, especially if it's an automatic defense cannon that has been dumped in place, because when it comes down to it, you wouldn't want someone just kind of making off with it. So, or just slashing the wires even. So I'm going to do something slightly different, for which I just need to control my copy my cannons across. So holding down shift. There's one. And there's two. Drop into perspective. Now as we can see, the bases on these ones are not okay, so have a look at that. I have no particular wish to kind of scale it in, because I don't think it'd look that cool scaled in. So there's a couple of things I can do really to kind of change it. My top viewport here. Got that bit. Quick FFD should do it. Wee, look at that. Have I got, oh yeah, probably have, haven't I? Ignore back facing. Silly me. And just there. I think I'll just have to space these further apart, because that's not really going to work. But that's okay, I can live with that. Because it's not a particularly hard thing to space these apart. Front viewport. I go over to here, select this part first, and then control select, hang on, using this bit. I believe I've got ignore bloody back facing on again. Sodding thing. Right, now go like this. And then move it to the right. Like so. Then grab this piece. And move it to there. Check that in perspective. Possibly a tiny bit close together on the bolts there, so I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt and just move this piece a little bit further away. There we are, just so you can see a slight gap between the feet. Then to there. Right, now for the other side. Again, making sure ignore back facing is turned off. Now I will select my element. Nice one, Chris. Okay, just there. It'll give our unit slightly more stability anyway. There we go. So now we have our cannon bay properly set up. And actually that's quite nice, I prefer the kind of width we're getting with that. Okay, next. 22 minutes in. Okay, so we're kind of reaching the end of building our gun barrel-y pieces. Although we could do with applying a little bit of a smooth to these fellows, so just press S to head down to smooth. What I tend to do is put auto smooth on at a threshold of about 24. See how that's holding out for us. About 27. 27 is a slight improvement. There we go. Okay, that's working out nicely. Now, next part then, I'm going to do some hoses and we'll have finished up the modelling piece. Hang on. Looks like some rivets decided not to make the final journey over as well. Intrigue. I'll just clean these off. Actually, no, I'll just move them to where they're supposed to be. Now I think about it. Yeah, there they are. Okay, there's another one in there. Oh, seriously, can't be asked to chase these around. Just fix them yourself in your own time. Otherwise, I'm going to be here forever. And I really don't want to be. There we go. Okay, so see you in the next bit. Thanks for watching.